The ultimate aim of karate is not victory or defeat, but the perfection of oneself. Hello, dear family and friends. For those who don't know me, I am Mac McCullough, and I have been a karate practitioner and teacher for many years. Specifically, I am part of Shotokan Karate of America, or as we call it, SKA. 15 years ago, on my 65th birthday, I did a karate presentation which lasted an hour and a half. Afterward, more than one person told me that was a bit too long. So today I have shortened it a lot. It would only take a few minutes. Please stay tuned. One other thing. This black belt was awarded to me directly by our Shihan, Tsurumu Oshima. It is his calligraphy which spells out my name and Shotokan Karate of America. Enjoy.
Kihan! Stepping out, left leg in on the right. Nice.
Here's a little humor, which my family will recognize. I began the practice of karate because I thought that my son needed discipline. So I took him with me to a karate practice. Oh, by the way, how did I find Shotokan Karate of America? Well, I was an actor at the time, and there was this woman involved with the show, and her boyfriend was a karate teacher. And I said to her, you know, I'm interested in karate, especially for my son. And I said, but I really want something that's really traditional and tough. Boy, did I get it. So I stayed. My son did not stay, not as long as I did, but I'm still here. If I could go back 50 years and tell my younger self some advice, what would it be? Definitely 100% go to college. Yeah, that opportunity escaped me. I still did okay in life, but by all means, go to college. So when I was young, I thought I wanted to be a psychologist. And I ended up being an electronics technician in the military, avionics specifically, very specifically, aviation electronics specializing in radar. That's quite a ways from psychology. And that was a better choice for me. It was an incredible experience. By the way, young people, if a Navy recruiter tells you join the Navy, it's an adventure, believe him. It was wonderful.
Hi!
I have found that life takes its twists and turns, and things that we end up doing we never had a clue that we would do. So we just have to be open-minded and open-hearted and do the best that we can.
You know, I stayed with karate even after my son did not continue. I stayed because I loved it. And it was incredibly fearful. I was scared witless. Every class I attended, there was blood. Blood on the gi, blood on the floor, blood on the arm, blood on the face. What a great practice. The practice of karate absolutely helped me to face any fear. Any fear. Whether it's emotional, physical, it just teaches us to face the fear. In fact, the favorite thing that instructors say all the time in a very, very difficult practice is, face yourself! Face yourself! It's wonderful. One of my favorite kata that I love is called Hangetsu. And it's a kata that is the ultimate form of karate, because it has very strong power, and it has expansion and contraction, and fast and slow, and these are all the principles of karate. But I had a senior instructor years ago in South Carolina, and when he did Hangetsu, at the end of it, he was dripping wet, soaking wet with sweat. So I'm not gonna do the whole thing, just a couple of moves, because we don't have time. Favorite moves. Hiyoda. Wait. Here's Hangetsu by Mac. Park a little bit. Hangetsu Yoi.
Finally, I would like to express my sincere gratitude for all of the many, many seniors who taught me well over the years, including my very first instructor, Doug Summer, Marty Cullenward, Walt Brannan, just everyone. I can't even think of so many names. I'm sorry for anyone I leave out, forgive me. And all of the special practices, all of the special training, and most importantly, Mr. Oshima, our Shihan, Sudama Oshima. And my final word is this. At this time in my life, I have no needs. I want no presents. This presentation today is my 80th birthday gift to you. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.